Welcome back everybody to another video. And if you have a Chromecast TV, guys, and you notice that it's running slow, or you notice that you're not quite getting the most out of it, because I'll be honest, when the Chromecast TV came out, I did not think it was the greatest device, and I still don't. But there are definitely some settings that we can go inside of the Chromecast TV and turn off or turn on that's gonna improve your overall performance on the device. So if you want to stick around, I'm going to be going through all of the best changes you can make to your Chromecast TV to make sure it's running 100% from day one. Like always, guys, if you're new to the channel, smash that subscribe button right down below here. It helps the content out a ton. Also, give this video a big thumbs up. And then if you can jump over on Twitter and follow me at upgrade_guy, it would really help me out a ton. Let's go ahead and get into today's video. All right, everybody, and before we go any further, I have to suggest you check out IPVanish. Now, if you want that extra layer of protection online, if you don't want people to know what you're doing online, including your internet service provider, then getting IPVanish gives you that extra layer of security. Now, down below in the description, it's 70% off, guys. Best discount you can get. It will bring you to my personalized page. And you don't need it, but it is a good extra added option. And you get 30 days risk-free, so get it. And then if you don't want it, just return it within 30 days. You get all of your money back. So really, there's no risk to at least trying it. So make sure you guys check out IPVanish today if you're looking for a VPN. Let's go ahead and get into today's video. All right, everybody. Now, this video is going to be pretty nonchalant. I'm just going to be going through the settings and showing you what I suggest changing up. Because there's some stuff that might annoy you about your Chromecast that you don't even know that you can change. So hopefully by the end of this video, you have a good idea. So we just have to start by going to the settings section. I have it right over here. It's kind of, you know, covered by my name, but not a big deal. So let's go ahead and open up settings. Now, like I said, I'm not a huge fan of the Google Chromecast TV. I thought there was so much more they could have done with it, but, you know, it is what it is. It's still a really good device, so there's definitely no hate on it at all. I just thought it could have been a step better at the end of the day. So set your device name. Of course, you guys can do that if you really want. You can also set pictures with it and stuff like that, but we're not going to worry about that today. That's pretty straightforward. Same with account sign-in. And stuff like that. But we'll start by going to the privacy section. Now there's a few things inside of here you can change, and that starts with location. So obviously they use your Wi-Fi to have a good idea of where you are, and there's a number of reasons they do that. One of that could definitely be for apps and different ads and sort like that as well, right? Because they want to personalize ads towards where you are. So you can always turn that off. I usually just turn it off. You just press it, that way you know it's off, and scanning isn't always available. As well, you can go here and have that turned off as well. So that's location-based services. But it's up to you. I just don't like giving them that extra little bit. I don't see why you would. Same with usage and diagnostics, I turn that off. And then when we go to ads, there's a lot of stuff you can change up inside of your Google account for your ads. So it's not actually changed up on the Chromecast as much, but you can see here you can opt out of personalized ads. So then it doesn't use your ad ID. It has a lot to do with tracking cookies that you pick up while you're on different websites, what you click on, what you search and stuff like that while you're using Google. This is really nothing new. So if you want to learn more about your ads on your account, you can go to your Gmail account, and there's actually, I believe, a whole section on ads you can check out. Where it'll teach you about it. We're not really going to get too much into it. I'll let you guys do that on yourself and look at how Google personalizes ads towards what you want, basically. Because obviously they want to sell you stuff at the end of the day. Google Assistant, there's not too much here you can look up, except for if you want to check searchable apps. So these would be apps where if you talk to your Google remote, you have it up to your mouth, they will scan for the show or movie or term that you say to your remote. So definitely can be useful, and you can set it up across all your apps as well. So I would definitely say a pretty useful feature. And that goes the same. You can have a safe search filter for youngins, and then personal results if you want as well. And we won't worry about the permissions quite yet. Now, in terms of purchases, there's really not much you have to worry about. I don't purchase a lot on mine. App permissions, we're going to leave that, and we can talk about that a little bit after. And special apps options has some cool stuff in terms of energy optimization and stuff. And I would probably turn that on any app. I don't see why having that off would benefit anything. But there is stuff such as usage access. So if you don't use the Bluetooth, if you don't use your Chromecast, you can always turn that off. If you don't want the Play Store or Play Services to have access, so say third-party apps and stuff like that, sometimes Play Services can disable those. That was a problem that started happening last year. You can definitely turn off Play Services as well, and then they won't have access to your device. And obviously turn that on back on anytime you want. So now let's head over to security and restrictions, where it's unknown sources. Now, I usually just check this on all the apps that I use that might need this. So for example, Downloader, which is a browser, you're gonna need that clicked in order to use it to download stuff, of course. Same with FX app, and then same with Quick Support when I access the device. But any other app, you really don't need a lot of the time the unknown apps access available, unless you're doing an update on that app, in which case it will want to install over top, and you'll need that access open to it. So that might be good to know for some of you. So now display and sound, there's really not much you have to change up in here unless you want to do advanced settings and get some sort of surround sound format set up. So if you have, you know, some sort of external system, then that might be something you want to do, but otherwise there's really nothing much in there. Now, when we go to our apps section, this is where I always tell people it's very important to make sure you look through your apps and find the ones that you don't use. So say you don't use Spotify and just uninstall it. Force stop, uninstall it, whatever you want to do. But if you're not using the app, it's just using up room, especially on a device like the Chromecast TV, where it only has very little storage. I think like 5 gigabytes available by the time you load it up. So don't bloat it up with all this stuff. As well, I would suggest when you're not using an app, now there are one-click cleaners that can do this exact same job. But when you're not using it, go inside and force stop the app. And that way it's all cleaned up and you don't have to worry about it running in the background, because when it's running in the background, it's gonna make your device run slower. There's no way around it. And then I usually clear cache, but like I said, there are one-click cleaners, so apps that do all that for you in a few seconds instead of going into settings and doing this. So it's a good little trick to know if you don't have a cleaner, but otherwise I would just use the cleaner. Now for special apps, access and apps permission, I only change these when the app 100% requires it. And you will see that from time to time, but usually that's only for like updates, right? Or depending if it's a voice search app, you'd probably need to allow it, right? But otherwise there's really not much to it. Now time for settings. Now there are some interesting stuff you can do in settings. Date and time and language is pretty straightforward. Same with keyboard. So we're not going to worry about all of that for now. But what I do want to show you is when you go to the about section, what we can do is actually access developer mode, which is going to give you some more options to customize your device. So if you scroll down until you find your Android TV OS build, that's the one that starts with QTS, you can press it 5 times until it says you are a developer. Now I'm already one, so you don't have to worry about it, but you will have to press it 5 times and that will make you a developer. And I'll show you what that allows you to do. So now when we go into at the bottom of this, you can see there's developer options that would appear now. It probably wasn't there before. And now from here, there's tons of different stuff you can set up that you wouldn't have been able to do before. So these more, I like to say advanced settings. And because there is stuff that you can change up that can make a major difference on your device, either for the good or for the bad. So obviously they don't want everybody playing around with these, but I will show you a few basic ones that I do use. So in terms of transition scale, window animation scale, I always just turn these off. So I'll give you an example of what transition scale is. So let's put it at times 10. So this will give you the extreme. Watch as I click back. Do you see how slow that transition is now? Now when we turned it to 0 and we turn this all to 0, watch how quick the transitions are in between the clicks. It's instant because there is no transition animation when we're clicking on stuff. So that does make going through your device significantly faster. Now, simulate secondary displays, we won't worry about that. There are a couple things you can play around with down here in terms of performance, but I suggest writing down which options you change. And that will allow you to change it back if you notice something not working well. And here's another really useful one, that force allow apps on external. So it makes an app eligible to be written on external storage regardless of a manifest valve. So with that, you should be able to, if you can hook a USB or micro USB micro SD card up to your Chromecast, which you should be able to do with a converter, I believe there is, like there is for the Fire Stick. Then you'll be able to do that and possibly get some more storage and apps written directly on the drive, so then you're not using the storage space on your Chromecast. So really good stuff there. Now, in terms of storage, there's not really much you can do here. You can see I had a SanDisk connected at some point with the same thing that I'm talking about with the little connector, which maybe I'll put into the description so you guys can use that. It's just a USB-C hub, I believe it is. Now there's some stuff in here, like you can go to your cache and clean your cache manually here as well, your device cache. And this will also give you a good idea in the storage option of what's using up so much room. So if you're noticing that it's always saying too much room on your device, you're running out of space, say you only have 500 megabytes left. Here you can see, well, what app's really using up all my room? Let's go in here because it's using up 1.9 gigabytes. What's using up a lot? Well, Netflix is using up 100, 100. We're not going to change those. But it gives you an idea of if there was one in here that's really bloating up space, like say CBC Gem, which I'm not going to use, you can just uninstall it. And that same, it'll show you for your photos and videos or downloads. If you have too much stuff, it'll show you how much space you have left and what you should get rid of. Other than that, guys, energy saver, obviously good to have on. I usually set it to 30 to an hour. That way it goes into sleep mode after a certain amount of period. But that was pretty much the full tutorial, guys. I know I kind of did it nonchalant, but I think it's the best way to talk about and teach you guys through the knowledge I've learned on these devices. So hopefully this was really helpful for you, and now you can get a little bit more out of your Chromecast and understand the settings a little bit better. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll check everybody in the next video.